They are the silent and loyal companions to each one of the Stark children. The direwolves in Game of Thrones are immensely popular, but that popularity has caused serious problems for huskies around the world.
Stefano from the Texas Husky Rescue is here to tell us exactly what's happening. But first of all, introduce us to these guys, because this guy I have right now is a leaner, and he's about to knock me over. Yeah, little buddy.
Who do we have? Tell us a little bit about him.
That is Uno, although today he's more known as Ghost, being here on the show. He's a new arrival with Rescue, so we're still getting to know this big, beautiful boy who thinks he is a lap dog.
Mm-hmm. You do, don't
Mike
you?
As Mike is very much discovering.
You're sweet, though, aren't you,
Next,
puppy?
We have little Valder, or not so little, at 67 pounds, the little black and white one here. He is a 15-month-old puppy. He came to us 11 months ago with epilepsy, a seizure disorder that we've had to get under control. Happy to say that we have, and while we booked him coming on the show as an available adoptee, in the last 2 days, his adoption has become final, and he will be
fantastic.
Leaving the program tomorrow.
Oh, that's always the great news to hear. And does he really have an obsession with Cheerios?
He does. He loves Honey Nut Cheerios. They are golden little nugget prizes. He eats half. He hides the other half around the furniture.
And last but not least.
And this is Bellin. When Texas Husky first made a permanent presence here in San Antonio 8 years ago, Bellin was the first dog that we saved. A severe cruelty seizure, Bellin was beaten and starved. Oh. And he's kind of become the local poster boy of our work. He has since gone on to become a pet partner therapy dog with the Therapy Animals of San Antonio and works with children in crisis all around the city.
So dogs become popular in shows like Game of Thrones, but these are not just your ordinary, everyday ordinary dogs, right?
They're not. I mean, they are, in the working breeds, they are high energy. They need lots of interaction, both mental and physical. And if people see them on TV, they fall in love with them with their obviously great looks. And they may not be ready for that type of dog. People need to do more breed research to make sure you are matching yourself with your dog.
That it would be a compatible fit.
And with their coats, though, I mean, they're made for winter. Are they overheated down here?
No, not really. The double coats act like insulation in a house. They help keep them cool in the summer and warm in the winter. It's just, no dog needs to be outside in a yard in San Antonio, August.
Of course.
So all these guys do love their air conditioning.
If people want more information about Texas Husky Rescue,
please visit our website at www.texashuskyrescue.org or on Facebook at Texas Husky Rescue.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. And you guys, yes, I'm glad you found a home, buddy. Good for you.